the spanning tree that we have seen so far is for the undirected and unweighted graph. If you consider a directed or undirected weighted graphs, then the minimal spanning tree will be defined like this. Minimal spanning tree is a tree constructed by using edges from the graph such that total weight of all the edges is least. That means you are supposed to construct a spanning tree with minimum number of edges or minimum weight edges. Using the vertices and edges of the given graph, we construct a tree which is connected such that the total weight of these edges is minimum. The newly constructed tree is called minimal spanning tree or optimal spanning tree. That means we are supposed to consider the weights of the edges. That means we need to apply this minimal spanning tree or optimal spanning tree concept on the weighted graphs. So in this we have two algorithms. One is Prim's algorithm, second one is Kruskal's algorithm. So the construction of minimal spanning tree will be like this. Let G be a connected graph. A subgraph T of G is called a spanning tree if G it satisfies the following condition. Obviously T is a graph, T is a tree, and T consisting of all the vertices of G. The edges are called branches. If the graph G has n vertices, then a spanning tree of G should consisting of n vertices and n minus 1 edges. This is the rule you are supposed to follow. If you are constructing a minimal spanning tree or a spanning tree for a graph G with n vertices, then the spanning tree should consisting of all n vertices and should have n minus 1 edges. In this we have two algorithms. One is Prim's algorithm and Kruskal's algorithm. What are the minimal spanning tree or optimal spanning tree that you form via Prim's algorithm or Kruskal's algorithm? They will look like same. A minimal spanning tree is a tree constructed by using the edges from the graph such that the total weight of all these graphs is least. Using the vertices and edges of the given graph, we construct a tree which is connected such that total weight of this graph is minimum. The newly constructed graph is called minimal spanning tree or optimal spanning tree. Let us see the Kruskal's algorithm. In order to see this Kruskal's algorithm, let us consider this graph. In this V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6 and V7. These are the vertices. And from V1 to V2, there exists an edge and a weight is associated with this edge. Whenever you draw an adjacency matrix, for the connectivity, to represent the connectivity between V1 to V2, instead of 1, that is, as we have seen in the previous lecture, instead of 1, we will mention it as 2. To represent the connectivity between V2 and V5, we will use the 10 as the value, that means the weight of the edge. So this particular graph is considered for our discussion. Kruskal's algorithm for optimal spanning tree construction. The step 1 in this Kruskal's algorithm is arrange all the edges in the ascending order of their weights and call this set as D. Whatever the edges are there, whatever the edges and connectivities are there, you are supposed to arrange all these edges and connectivity in the ascending order of their weights. That means you are supposed to sort the connectivities between the vertices of the graph. Step 2. Select the edge from the set D when as the least weight, remove it from D and place it in the tree. Since you have arranged all the edges in the sorted order, that is ascending order, you pick up the edge connectivity which is having the minimum weight and remove it from the set D and place it in the tree. If this placing do not form a cycle, then continue. Else, neglect the edge to place in the tree. That means if you might have picked up a minimum connected vertices, and if you place it in the tree, then if that placing is forming a cycle, then avoid that edge to be placed in the minimal spanning tree or spanning tree construction, because spanning trees should not consisting of any cycles. Step 3, take the next edge with the least weight from the edge set D and continue this procedure using step 2. You keep on repeating this. Continue this procedure until the set D is empty. That means all the edges that are available in the D was checked. Till the time you continue this particular procedure. For n vertices of this graph, if there are n minus 1 edges, then the constructed spanning tree is correct. How you will check whether the construction is correct? For n vertices of this graph, if there are n minus 1 edges, then the constructed spanning tree is correct. This is the condition need to be checked once the construction is over. Now consider this graph. You are supposed to, first, as per the Kushkal's algorithm, step 1 is you are supposed to arrange the edges in the ascending order. Ascending order will be like this: v1, V1 to V4, okay. V1 to V4, the weight is 1. V6 to V7, V6 to V7, the weight is 1. V1 to V2, weight is 2. V3 to V4, weight is 2. Like that, the edges that are connected having the weights are arranged in the sorted order. That is arranged in the ascending order of their weight. Okay, this is what the step 1 is. Arrange all the edges in the ascending order of their weights and call this particular set as D. So I am calling this particular set as D. Now take the select the edge from the set D then as the least edge. Okay, that means you pick up one edge from this particular set D and which is having the minimum weight. So obviously V1 comma V4 is having the minimum weight. So V1 comma V4 was taken out and added to the tree. So V1 comma V4 you have added to the tree. Next, V6 comma V7 is having minimum. V6 comma V7 is added to the tree. Next, V1 comma V2, which is 2. V1 comma V2 is added to the tree. And check whether any cycle was formed or not. Here no cycles were formed. V3 comma V4 is the edge which is having the minimum weight as 2 or weight as 2, that will be added to the tree. So V3 comma V4, which is added to the tree. Now check, is there any cycle was formed? There is no cycle was formed. Next, V2 comma V4. So V2 comma V4, if you add it, then it will form a cycle. Like V1, V4, V2 and again V1. So you are supposed to avoid this V2 comma V4 edge to be connected in the spanning tree. Next, V4 comma V7. So try to add V4 comma V7. V4, V7. Check for any cycle formed or not. So there is no cycle was formed. So you can happily add this particular V4 comma V7. Next, V1 comma V3. V1 comma V3. If I add this V1 comma V3 into this tree, then this will form a cycle. So we are supposed to avoid this V1 comma V3. Next, V3 comma V6. V3 comma V6. If I add this V3 comma V6, then it will form a cycle like a V3, V4, V7 and V6. V6 to V3 again. So it will form a cycle. So we are supposed to avoid V3 comma V6 to be added into the tree. Next is V5 comma V7. So V5 comma V7, if you add, does it form any cycle? No, it is not forming any cycle. So we can add this particular V5 to V7. Next, V4, V5. So if I add V4 to V5, so it will form a cycle. So cycle should not be there in the spanning tree. So this particular V4, V5 is avoided. Next is V4, V6. V4, V6, if you add, obviously it will form a cycle. So V4, V6 to be avoided. Next is V2, V5. V2, V5, if you add, then it will form a cycle V1, V2, V5, V7, V4 and V1. So this particular edge to be added should be stopped or should be avoided. So finally, V2, V4, V3, V6, V4, V5, V4, V6 and V2, V5 are the edges we have avoided to add in the spanning tree. Once all these edges visiting is over, then we'll check whether all the vertices in the tree are connected or not. Then whenever we check this connected connected edges, vertices, there are total 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 vertices. How many edges are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 edges. According to the verification process, for n vertices of this graph, if there are n minus 1 edges, then the constructed spanning tree is correct. So that means we have 7 vertices and we have 6 edges. For n vertices, we have n minus 1 edges. So this particular construction of the spanning tree is the minimal spanning tree, and we can say confidently that whatever the spanning tree that we have constructed is correct. This is what the Kruskal's algorithm. Let us see the algorithm for the Kruskal's algorithm, Kruskal's implementation. In the minimal spanning tree, in this particular minimal spanning tree implementation, we have seen the edges and corresponding weights. So what is the best algorithm that can be used so that we can pick the minimum weighted edge, or minimum weighted edge can be picked easily within the constant time? So we have seen previously binary heaps. Okay, we have seen binary heaps. In these two categories we have seen, one is min heap, another is max heap. In the min heap, the root element will be in the will be minimum element. While going down the tree, so there will be incrementing in the values, or there will be more larger values will be there in the down the tree. But always the root element will be the minimum element. Whenever you remove the minimum element, you will do percolation operations so that the next minimum element will be at the root. In the same way, in the Kruskal's algorithm, I will use the binary heap operation. For what purpose I will use this binary heap? I will use this binary heap to maintain the to pick the minimum weighted edge in the graph. So whenever you form or construct a minimum heap with the edges, you don't need to sort anything. You can perform simple, you can go for construction of the simple heap tree, that is minimum heap tree, and you can pick the value. So obviously it will maintain the complexity as log n. But if you use any bubble sort or quick sort or any other thing, even though it is giving you n log n time, or if in case of bubble sort n square time, the time complexity increases. So that is reason for picking up, we need a constant complexity, and for adjustment log complexity. So for that, we have seen previously binary heap will give us will help us in our situation. So I am using the binary heap here. That is the minimum heap I am using. Algorithm Kruskal of epsilon cost comma n comma t. For I is equal to 1 to n, do parent of I is equal to minus 1. I is equal to 0, minimum cost is equal to 0. While I is less than n minus 1, and that means that we should have n minus 1 number of edges. And heap not empty. That means whatever the minimum heap is not empty, then you are supposed to perform this particular, you are supposed to repeat this loop. Delete a minimum cost edge, okay, u comma v, from the heap, and reheapify and edges. So obviously reheapifying will take log time. Picking will take constant time, that is order of one. So j is equal to find of u, k is equal to find of b. If j is not equal to k, then I is equal to I plus 1, t of I comma 1 is equal to 0, and t of I comma 2 is equal to b. Now the how you calculate the minimum cost? Minimum cost is equal to minimum cost plus the cost of the next corresponding edges u comma v. Then what, once you get the minimum cost, you union, that is you union these edges into the into this particular tree. So you are supposed to repeat this till the I is less than or equal to, less than n minus 1. That means all the n minus 1 edges you have connected. If I is not equal to n minus 1, that means once this particular loop is executed and comes out, and if the I value is not equal to n minus 1, then you simply print on the screen that minimum spanning tree construction is not possible. Otherwise, you return the minimum cost with which the minimum spanning tree is constructed. This is a simple algorithm for the Kruskal's algorithm, minimum spanning tree construction. The time complexity of this Kruskal's algorithm is order of n square, where n is the number of vertices. As the number of vertices increases, the complexity also increases. The time complexity of Kruskal's and Prim's algorithm are one and the same, that is order of n square, where n is the number of edges. Now we'll see the implementation of Kruskal's algorithm. So the minimum spanning tree via Kruskal's algorithm will be calculated like this. For this, we use set operation called union and find operation. For initially, a set will be initialized to null. For each vertex v belongs to V of G, do make set of V, sort the edges of E into non-descending order by weight V W. For each edge u comma v belongs to E, taken in non-descending order by weight, do if find set of u is not equal to find set of v. That means there should not be common vertex. If there exists common vertex, then it will form a cycle. So we are supposed to avoid the cycle in the Kruskal's algorithm. Then A will be assigned as the vertex, that is set which is belong to u comma v, that is in the union, and return A. So as it is, like in the previous coding, so the number of vertices I have considered as 7. For this I have considered a graph as shown here. Here v1, v2, v3, v4, v5, v6 and v7, total 7 vertices are there, and corresponding weights are also there. When there is no connectivity, I have mentioned infinity. Otherwise, I have placed the corresponding distance. The same was mentioned in the static array of two-dimensional array with the number of vertices as 7, which is going to represent the graph in the adjacency matrix form. In this, we need to remember the parent of the visiting node. So parent of the number of vertices, that I have made a temporary arrangement to hold the number of parent related values. If this parent of number of vertices will be useful for union and find algorithm, the minimum spanning tree of three dimensional array, so that is used here, that is number of vertices cross 3 is used. This is especially for holding the edges and corresponding weights. So this is to hold the minimum spanning tree, that array is mentioned here. Now Kruskal's underscore MST, here union in the sense here union of two edges. So for this, if the inserting union edges are not equal, then parent of j is equal to I. This is what the union, and find means we are supposed to find the parent of a given number or given vertex. Next is Kruskal minimum spanning tree, in which we are supplying the adjacency matrix. So here distance array, number of edges, because the number of edges will be less than the number of vertices. That is, as if the number of vertices are n, then the number of edges will be n minus 1. So the number of edges is equal to 1 initialization. was done, and net many number of edges to the, till the net many number of edges we are going to iterate, and we are going to find the minimal spanning tree. And here some variables were mentioned, variable to hold the indexes a, b, u, v, like that. And minimum distance I am going to mention here. While number of edges is less than the number of vertices, then for I is equal to 0, minimum distance is equal to infinity, and I is less than number of vertices, I plus plus. Then if the adjacency matrix of ij is less than the minimum distance, then minimum distance is equal to adjacency matrix of ij, and you hold the corresponding vertices and go for finding of u and finding of v, whether these two are you are supposed to get the parent of u and v. And once you get it, then you check for the union. That means if it is present in the union, then it will return. That means if I and j is not equal, then it will return the parent. Otherwise, it will return zero. So whenever the parent was returned, then you are supposed to print that particular edge and corresponding weight, and the number of edges to be incremented. And whatever the indexes that we got here, that means which is already visited, for them we are going to reinitialize it to infinity, so that this particular vertex will, sorry, this particular edge will not be visited again, so that we can avoid the cycles. Once it is done, then in main method Krushkal underscore mst of the static graph that I have created here. This graph is similar to the graph that we have discussed in the lecture, that will run the code and we'll see. So this is the edges, that is 1 to 4 and 6 to 7, 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, like that. Because I have decremented it one by one, so you are supposed to increment it by one, this vertex number, and you match with the graph minimum spanning tree that we have seen in the lecture. So this is regarding the Krushkal's algorithm for the minimum spanning tree.